This is a demo video of the Oak Ridge Model 888-2 Digital Key Control / Echo Mixing System. It's traditionally used as a karaoke amplifier. You have on the back a bunch of RCA inputs and video inputs so that you can switch quickly between different karaoke units. And in the front you have three microphone inputs. Mic 1 has its own volume. Mic 2 and 3 have their volumes ganged together on one pot. There's a music volume knob here, which I'll go over later. There's bass and treble controls, which are kind of subtle, not super obvious. And then echo is the amount of the echo in the signal. Delay is the delay time, and repeat is how many repeats. I don't totally understand utaoki and voice/seal, although I might imagine that as voice canceling and auto/R. Anyway, selector selects between the different inputs, and then there's a digital key control, which I'll go over in just a minute. So I have a simple kick snare beat coming in. So I'll show off the delay first. And notice that the mic 1 volume is right at about 8 o'clock on the dial. That's fairly low, so of course you can get it to really nasty, crunchy very quickly, because it's expecting a mic level signal, so it's amplifying it quite a bit. Anyway, here is some echo. I'll change the delay time. As you notice, I'm turning the delay up and the delay time is getting shorter. It's a little bit counterintuitive to me. Typically, you find longer delay times when you turn clockwise and shorter delay times when you turn counterclockwise. Now I'll turn up the repeats. So the modifications that I did on the rear of the unit, basically the output is feeding the input through the VD input, and there's a pot potentiometer on the back where you can change the amount of gain that the feedback loop is receiving, but it also affects the delay repeats. So once we get to about noon and above, it starts to self-oscillate a bit. And it can easily go into super self-oscillation. So then with the delay all the way up, just to show that mic 2 and 3 work. Okay, and here's some of the bass boosted. It actually seems alright on this system, and it does cut the bass a little bit. Treble's not so steep or intense of a curve. Okay, now I'll show you the feedback loop. So you can start to hear a little bit of delay creeping in. So I've shifted up one half note. So basically the feedback is feeding back on itself and shifting it up one half step every delay cycle. So then we'll go up one whole step. So the music volume controls the amount of feedback into the pitch. Now we're going up three half steps and two whole steps. So it can get pretty crazy pretty quickly. Also on the back, what I've included is I found on the chip that controls the delay here, I found some clocking tones, which I'll show you real quick. So then let's get it on there, and we'll put... Actually, we don't need the signal in anymore because we're taking it directly out of the tones. So here's the high. So as I adjust the delay time, it's basically an oscillator. And then the mid is the same note, but just an octave lower, I believe. And then there's the octave lower than that, or maybe it's two octaves, I don't remember exactly. Now you'll notice when I sweep it all the way down to the lowest possible setting, there you start to get some higher octave in there. It's a weird, fun artifact. So there it is, no high frequency tone. And there, the high frequency tone is sweeping in. So that's the three individuals. There's also a delay output.